Welcome to Late to the Show. I'm your host, Prophet 74. Today we're going to talk a little bit about the Dell Inspiron 5675. If you guys purchase it, you guys probably recognize the motherboard. I opened it up, I took it apart, I replaced a couple items, but I got a lot of questions about this, and this is something that a lot of people want to upgrade their motherboard, their CPU, their GPU, and the power supply, or the whole tower itself. Now, it's a little difficult, and I'm going to explain to you on a couple of moving components in here and what it takes to actually migrate this motherboard to another system, another case, for example. Unfortunately, you're not going to be able to migrate this motherboard to another case because I'm going to show you guys a couple of things that are off of it, and it doesn't fit on very well, especially when it comes down to the power. The power is a little different. It can only generate the power for the actual CPU, the GPU that it came with. If you want to add a different power adapter, you can, but this is the problem right here, the CPU connection. If you have a converter to the 4-pin connection, or you have an older power adapter that has that, then you might be able to. But the new generation of GPUs require at least 16 pins now these days, and especially if you're going to transfer to NVIDIA, it's going to be a little hassle. You're going to have to upgrade the power. Unfortunately, I wish I could show you a better method for how to do this, but I'm going to show you those that want to migrate their systems. You can't migrate this system and put it to work on in any case you want, but you have to do modifications, and let me show you what you need to do. All right. All right, so the unique part of this motherboard is that a lot of things are not upgradable on it because, for example, the power itself. You can run the motherboard on it. You can run it perfectly fine. You can plug it in. It fits very well in here. But you're going to have problems upgrading this power, the CPU part. And that's where I ran into it. When you try to put a CPU component in there, there's not enough pins. So this is the CPU one, and the least I could get of pins is actually 6 pins. There is no fit in here. You have to probably buy a converter kit to convert this into the powers for the CPU, but you have the power for the motherboard. That's going to work fine. So what you have to do is probably migrate your old power supply into it, but the power supply is not enough pins for the newer GPUs. If you want an RTX video card, you're not going to be able to. What you can salvage out of this old system is going to be the GPU, the video card, the memory, and that's about it. Now, to migrate to a new motherboard, that means you're going to have to reinstall the OS completely in there. And of course, a lot of you know it's very difficult to even remove and replace this the actual hardware, but I'm letting you guys know it's not that hard if you have some experience or you want to watch videos about how to replace CPUs or GPUs. Just come and watch them here. I got a couple of tutorials how to do that. Now, the M.2 replacement is very simple. You unscrew two screws and you take it out. One screw and you take it out and pull it apart. Memory is very simple. Two slots memory. They open up, they split open, and that's it. Now, you can migrate this to a new tower, but there's other complications that you have to be aware. And the other complication is this monstrosity here. All these connections in here that connect back to the motherboard, you're going to have to find a slot. And some of these towers don't have front slots, or you have a unique slot where it actually takes certain inputs. A lot of these places, what people do is they start taking face plates and cutting through it and also melting it on the plastic versions of it. So you're gonna have to migrate this part, which this one retains your type C, your 3.0 and your USB, and you're including your SD card reader, which a memory card reader, and also including the audio in here. So that's another thing that you're gonna have to migrate with you. If not, if you're willing to sacrifice these things and you could plug in your motherboard within there, you can do that. So on the motherboard itself, they give you a couple slots here, type C, type 3, and they give you the SSD connections. All these SSD connections are for the USBs that they have. Plenty of slots in here for the SATA connection, but to modify those are a little difficult. You have to go into a motherboard BIOS and change them in there. You could migrate the wireless. It's not that hard. You take these two things, they have attachment, they have adhesive. You can put them, attach them anywhere, or add your own. Now, regarding the reset button, there's a reset button in here, and this is the reset button that in front of the panel. And this is the only thing I could not replace, but there's options out there that you can replace the button. So right here, this button right here, it only fits one direction. On this button right here, there's actually a couple items that you can do. There's a 4-pin connection that you have to, it's actually 5-pin connection that you plug it in here. And there's a missing one in here. But what was I able to do is just find the actual power connection, which are the two first pins in the front here, and go ahead and connect them, replace them. So you can replace this and modify it. You can purchase yourself a reset button and a power button here. And let me show you this. And if you guys never seen this before, they sell these reset buttons. These are perfect to modify your computer to add your own reset button. Now this one lights up. This one has a little bit more of the things that you don't really require. You know, it's just an overkill for me, but it comes with the actual power reset button here, and that's what you need to turn it on. And it also is the power LED plus and LED negative too. Now these could be avoided. You don't have to put them in there and here in this area. On the power reset button, you add it in here. That's pretty much the first two pins in the beginning of it, and that's where you actually have your power button. You could replace that button in there. Now if your tower has that, you could actually plug it in there, and that's pretty much how it does it. Instead of the original one that comes with it, the reset button, if you can't migrate this button, or if you could modify it and solder it from the original to the tower, then go ahead and upgrade it. But my best thing is probably buy yourself a reset button, something fancy if you want, something simple, or take the existing connection and plug it in that slot right now. But unfortunately, you're not gonna put the LED plus or negative. It's just the power reset button. And that's what this is pretty much. This is all in one. It's actually an LED reset button. And this is the original button that I migrated. I actually took off and I still have it for references here. So I'm gonna remove this and plug this back so I'm gonna lose it. So unfortunately you can't migrate a lot of things from here. So like I said, the only thing I was able to get out of this system was the actual memory, the CPU, GPU, and that's about it. And the M.2, which is the SSD. That's the only thing I migrated. Other than that, I had to replace the motherboard and the case itself. So my recommendation, scratch this, throw it away. There's nothing you can do on this one. It was made for Dell, and there's a lot of things that they don't want you to mess with it. Then that's the only reason they set it up to this. And they make it so complicated to migrate this motherboard into any kind of tower. This will fit in any tower, but you do have to modify some holes in there, maybe some modifications here and there. And then to migrate this is kind of an impossible task. You're gonna have to leave this behind and go with the new stuff. And there is connections. Let me unplug these right here so you guys can see all the existing connections. On this part right here in the motherboard is a USB 3.0. And this one is Type-C, USB Type-C right here, the 3.1. On here, if you guys could see it, this is the actual card reader. And then they give you the USB 2.0. So you have a couple of options you can do. You can use all these four options if you want to. But, and then they give you extra fans in the back. So there's a couple of fans that you can take in here. One, two. All right, so there's only a couple of slots for fans. If you can see, I found one here, two in the back. And then here, this is the LED lights. This is the 4-pin LED lights. They do have converter here for the RGB lighting. And these are the things that you can migrate from existing motherboards, existing towers to this system. So if you're gonna migrate that stuff, you're gonna require to make sure that your tower has these connections. If you don't have these, you're gonna have to have other options. And I do have other options in my videos where you guys can see it, how to add extra USBs if you have plenty of slots. And we have plenty of slots in here. We have one for the GPU, and you can add extra slots in here, which is great. So if you ever run out of space on one of the slots and you have enough USBs, you can always add this one too. And this one works pretty good. It fits on any of the slots that they come with it. So it has the newer versions of all the slots in here. All you do require some power in here, and you are going to require four pin, or if you in the newer versions, the SATA connections. And then you have an internal USB. You can plug anything in here. And then you have the external four USBs. You could always upgrade your system. And if you need to upgrade to a Type-C, you can do a Type-C too. They do have another slot, Type-C. And like I said, it fits anywhere. But this one's actually going to be made for the PCIe ports, which is where your video cards go. And this one actually is set up for this. And if you can notice, it's plugged in here. But it's also going to require a SATA power connection in here in order to make it work. So if you migrate this and you ran out of space or fan or require extra additional stuff, I do have other videos that show you how to add extra fan connections on something like this. You could even split this USB 2.0 into a 4 or 5 different slots. And I'm gonna show you right now what you can do. So anybody that wants to migrate this, it's very simple. You can always add fans, and they do sell this NZXT hub that you could sacrifice that one USB, and this one could convert into more fans for you, or more USB, internal USB connections, because some of these towers have multiple USBs that connections that require. Now this one has 5. This one has the pins, and actually it has the 2.0 connections. Now for additional fans, I recommend this device, and I actually reviewed it. And this one's a 2-pin device with a USB, and this is a 12 volt, but they do make a 5 volt. 12 volt is going to generate more air in there, faster. Faster rotations too. So you can have this one, and they do have a 5V, which is a slower connection, but it does the same thing. It does pretty much brings a lot of airflow in there. But if you have a case that has multiple fans, this is not going to have all the requirements or the power connections that you require for those fans. So a thing that you want to migrate on this one, if you're ever going to migrate your motherboard to a new tower, you're going to have to migrate also the power, and you're going to have to leave this behind, because this is very complicated connections, and it's only made for the Dell tower. Unfortunately, Dell locked this down where a lot of things that cannot be migrated. So if you guys have any questions or anything like this, let me know. I'm your host, Prophet74, and we're out.